so on stitch on the pocket side. So we're going to run stitch. We measure 1 inch. Then we use a yardstick or measuring stick to join. So the same thing will also take place here. Same with this. So I will now run the stitch. While running the stitch, I will run the stitch from 0 to 3. I will now give about 4 inches space. I now finish up the remaining. So this is 3 inches and this is 4. So because of our time, I may not be showing us all the pockets, but this is the exact where we are going to run it. So this is the exact way we are going to run all the whole pockets, both this and this. So after then, the next thing we're going to do is we go to our table to flatten this, the sleeve of this. We also flatten this to press it, to iron it, and if there will be a kind of a little hole on the center of the pocket, and then we will open press this on the table. So these are the things we are going to do now if we go to our table, and then after then we return back to continue with our stitching. We are done with the ironing. We open pressed here, and this is the dart. We open press the dart. This is the front of it. So, and also this is the sleeve. This is the sleeve. Here's how it is. And these are the pockets. These are the two side pockets. And this is the breast pocket. These pockets, they will have flap, just as I said before. And we are going to use this to construct the flap right after the sewing of the pocket. We construct this flap using the measurement of the mouth or the wideness of the pocket. Using the measurement of the wideness of the pocket. So we start by fixing the pocket. After fixing the pocket, we now sew the flap, measure and sew the flap. Then we sew the flap inside the pocket. And the next thing is to cut the lining. We commence now by fixing the pocket or sewing the pocket. So before we sew the pocket, we need to mark here. This is from the bottom line, from the bottom we make 10, mark 10 inches. So, and from here we mark 5.5 inches. This is where the pocket falls. So we will also mark this, the opposite side. from the bottom to mark 10, mark 10 inches, and from this point to mark 5.5. And this is where the pocket goes. And that of the breast pocket, that of the breast pocket, from the top here, we mark 9.5. And from this point, we mark 3.5. This is where our pocket, breast pocket falls. So we are going to commence with sewing. So we run stitch on the pocket, giving space on the side. I forgot to show us how we prepare the pocket. Just after the gumming, I cut it on a curved place and I use my iron to fold it. Thereafter, I now put hemming gum on the right inside. Here we just fold. That is why it laps on the opposite side. So this is it. And the same way we will do this. And all of this. And this is the metal gap I was in. That we need to create the reason why we do space during the sewing. So we continue with the pocket, the sewing of the pocket. Attach the breast pocket. Going to show on the opposite side to the pit done with the fixing of this pocket. So the next thing I'm going to do is to I'm going to sew the flap. So these are for the flap, and we measure the pocket, the wideness of the pocket. We have is 5 for 1 button, and the flap will also be 5 for 1 button. I made a mistake by cutting out from the space I still have, so I need to reduce both of them. So, next thing we will give a cut here. You press it to make sure that the arrow mark or the pointed mark is out. So, and the same way we turn this one. So we just made two of these. The next we complete it. This is for the third one, which is the press pocket area. So after then we will go to iron this. And after ironing we will now fix it. Fix it to the pocket. So I'm going to run a stitch on this one. Let's iron the flap of the pocket. So we will run stitch by the side first. I'm going to attach the flap to the pocket by running stitch on it. Attach that on the rest of it. We are done with this, so we will attach this one. not done with this. The next thing we're going to do now, we are going to run a